Hello and welcome to your Active's EU Tweets of the Week. This week, leaders toss coin for photo op, it's not easy getting into COP, and Council of Europe debate, please just stop. This episode is supported by ENSO-E, more about their upcoming Net Zero conference later on. Let's begin this week in Italy, where at the G20 world leaders tossed a coin at Trevi for good luck fighting the climate emergency, which immediately prompted two kinds of reactions. First, we're all going to die. And second, not gonna lie, I was a little worried about climate change before I saw this. Rohida Kadambi called it the Lizzie McGuire climate strategy. Yes, it's a very niche reference. Deal with it. Mohamed El-Sheikhi, meanwhile, was more worried about the funding. Oh no, that was all the money they set aside to fight climate change. And Flavia Gabriela Sandu went a different way. Have we considered, I don't know, concrete policy to fight climate change? Doesn't make such a good photo background though, I know. But let's move on to the main event, COP26, which produced plenty of iconic pictures, like these two, which, as François Germain pointed out, might just become a symbol of the conference. Or the equally symbolic fact that all trains to Glasgow were suspended due to a weather-related event, with hundreds of delegates to a climate conference stuck in Houston because the UK's infrastructure just isn't resilient to climate change. All while a massive COP had read, no time for delay, which resulted in hundreds of people booking last-minute short-haul domestic flights to COP26 in Glasgow as both train lines have broken down. Lovely stuff indeed. In front of the venue, Darren McCaffrey said Britain is in fine form showing off our favourite pastime, queuing. But hey, at least he made it in. Israeli Energy Minister Karin El-Harar wasn't provided a handicap accessible entrance and was led from one entrance to another for 2 hours. And at one point, the COP26 venue had reached capacity, with one tweeter saying, it's like trying to get into a late nightclub, one in, one out. Cool. But what about decisions? Well, as Le Chou reported, Brazil's president promises to stop deforestation, world leaders forget he's a dishonest liar. And DG Meme broke the news that world leaders have reached a final agreement on climate. It sucks in Glasgow. This episode is supported by ENSO-E. If you can't get enough of climate conferences, you can join their Net Zero conference on Friday, the 26th of November, by registering online. And now to something completely different, but at the same time very, very old debate. What should women wear in public? As Rim Kadri reported, France asked the Council of Europe to remove a video they posted in support of the right of women to wear a hijab. And the Council of Europe removed it. Because, you know, nothing screams women's self-determination more than a group of middle-aged men cheering for the removal of a campaign to let women decide what to wear. Alison Abraham said she was shocked that the Council of Europe removed the video, but not shocked that France asked them to remove it. And Marine Kahn drew another comparison. If the Council of Europe deleted a hate speech campaign video because Orban's government accused it of promoting LGBTI rights, the Brussels bubble might be having a different type of conversation today. And in another leader tweet, one French journalist called for Charles Michel to resign over the incident. Just only a tiny little problem? Wrong council. Ah yes, the European Council versus the Council of Europe, the internal struggle, tweeted MEP assistants. And Pablo Perez imagined the Squid Game-inspired challenge to tell the difference between the European Council, the Council of Europe, and the Council of the EU. And that's it for another week. Join us again next Friday for more snarks and larks from the Brussels bubble Twittersphere.